Ahoy, mateys! I'm Captain Bumbles, and welcome to Captain Bumbles Plays and Criticizes, which is a new series. Like, cause I was thinking to myself the other day, and I'm like, well, I have a tendency to make it just a whole bunch of random videos, and usually most people go to certain peoples for certain things, and I thought it'd be a fun thing to play some games that may or may not played and criticize them. Like, Archeage would be a good example. I like it, but there's some problems with it. Well, I wouldn't say like there's issues playing the game. They're just game mechanics that people frowned upon. Let's say this labor system down here, you know. Have you ever played a Facebook game or a mobile game that had like an energy bar? In other words, you know, once you run out of energy, you can't do anything. But mostly labor is used for, you know, collecting materials like chopping down trees, you know, collecting fruit, you know, anything, you know, that wise. But it used to be where, see, the main coin of the currency is when you kill stuff, you drop the coin person. Like it says, spend 3 labor to unlock it so you can get some money. Which most people aren't too fond of that. I think it's kind of dumb. Or it's a... I guess a pay to have fun. I read a review on Steam and it's a pay to win. I wouldn't call it pay to win. I would call it pay to have fun. Because, you know, there's not a whole bunch of, you know, because in this game it's not really much a pay to have fun. To pay to win. It's more of a pay to have fun, depending on who you are. Because to me, I have fun either way playing this game. I like the game. There's some issues. You know, the labor system. You know, a lot of people will comment on that, and I'm going to find a way to cope with it. And cope, this means to get along with it and use it to my best ability, because with this, you know, by default, free-to-play members have the max of 2,000 labor points. I have 4,000. I was a patron once, but I decided, I'm not gonna play. I was gonna wait until my buddies joined in and we do something like this, determine if we liked it or not. And, you know, because I mostly determine if a game's good or not, if, you know, if I like it. But when I want to invite a whole bunch of buddies to play, they may like, because the first thing you mention with people about this game is once you mention the labor system, they're like, oh, that doesn't sound fun. I'm like, no, it is fun. It's just different. No, I really do like, there's some pretty cool things. I like this create your own class thing, where it's pretty much, you choose, there's like 10 different skills, and you pretty much choose one skill, then you choose another one, then choose another one at level 10, then... Because the movement, the combat's pretty good. I like it. You got different moves that you can use. The name of combos. I chose the Battle Rage, the defense, and Occultism. Occultism's like a spell, but I only took the ones that like don't require me casting a whole bunch. So I had a quest to, you know, kill stuff. I don't have a problem. I don't have a problem with grinding a lot. Because I actually enjoy it. So. And two, with the new revelation out there, I'm like, okay, let's see what else they added to it. And they fixed some of the problems, because every now and then, when you loot stuff, you actually get money. Now, instead of, you know, getting the stupid coin purses, you know, that was like something like, dude, really? And I like, it's a good, part of me says it's a good game in some areas, but when you want to build a house, as you do with the sandbox feature stuff, everybody's like, this game's shit. But to be honest, I have to get a whole bunch of buddies together, because, see, the labor system, a lot of people crap on it, but it's just one of those things where you just can't, you know. Like, let's say World of Warcraft, you know, only thing you really need was a pickaxe, and you can mine the whole entire land and back again and make a whole bunch of money. It's just the labor system, pretty much. Like, I can understand they're trying to go for realism, but like, how like some of your characters get fatigued after working a hot, such long, hard day, you know, I can understand that. It's pretty cool. I like it. You know, if they would maybe, because I don't know, like, I would say maybe if they got rid of the labor system, maybe a whole bunch of people go to it. But then again, I've been seeing a whole bunch of life from the other servers. Because there's ads for the Revelation update everywhere. Oh shit. Leave him alone, leave Steelboat alone, you asshole. Staring death in his face. Oh god. Okay. I'm trying to hit. I got a combat pet, which is this little hedgehog. I named him Steelbolt. I made a Yu-Gi-Oh reference. Steelbolt Hedgehog is his full name. So meet Steelbolt. He looks pretty badass. What a badass motherfucker. He's a BAMF. You're fucked. I like it. If you ever play games like Terra, where you have different combo moves, because, well, in Terra, it's really like, I would say, you know, press like space or, oh god, we're another character. Thank you, Willow. God damn it. You just want to be left alone in peace, you assholes. At least, luckily for, he has the ability to heal himself. Is not too bad. Come on, Steelboat. That's going on an adventure. Really, there's a quest giver here. Okay, let's go do you. I'm sorry if my nose is... Oh, yeah, I forgot. Happy Merry Christmas, because I probably upload this into December around Christmas, so I hope you have a Merry Christmas and be safe. Be safe. Because I like this game, I really do. But if you look on the Steam reviews, it has a mixed opinion. Some people liked it, some people love it. Well, wait, I should rephrase that. Some people like it, some people love it, and some people, you know, dislike it, and some people hate it. You know, it's got the. I know that, I know the American. Because I know, what I understand is, the American team can't edit a whole bunch of it without the Korean team's permission. Because I know there's like a Korean version in Korea of Archeage. What I understand is the American team doesn't... can't do crap. Can't do crap. You know, they can't do much without the Korean team's permission. And so they pretty much follow what they do, and it's like, well, they're their boss, so you don't really go against them or go rogue. So. Collect one Sunbite Harpy Egg. What's, Yeah, it's pretty cool. I like the different armor. The armor sets have like a rock, paper, scissors to them. Kind of feel like leather beats cloth, cloth beats plate, and plate beats leather. And the reason why I say this, because leather, I know, I haven't looked what like cloth armor does, but judging from the feel from plate armor and, from plate armor and leather, because leather gives you like I get mostly defense, you know, complete plate set, you know, I get a bonus for that, you know, that's pretty cool, you know, increased defense by 30%, max health by 5%, also decreased duration of stuns and jackals by 20%, which is pretty damn good. Now if we open up my bag, which is we can look at the leather, which, you know, let's see, look at the leather, because, let's go with the chest piece, you know, see, like, the plate does, you know, defense, you know, that's 800, that's pretty damn good, strength, good, stamina, good, as a melee fighter, that's pretty good, intelligence, I believe it may be spell, I don't remember. Let's see. Oh yeah, I forgot. I have that. Because usually when you find new armor and stuff, okay, well, how does one get off the rope? Oh, that's how. And usually when you find new stuff, you know, it used to cost labor points, but now it doesn't. Because see, the max for a free-to-play member is 2,000. Like I said, I used to be a patron, so... patron's the fancy word for member, so I have 4,000. And so part of me's... No, matching set, woohoo! And, like, this is a random piece I got off some dead dude. Oh, it did cost labor points. Never mind. Because I know at lower levels it costs some. Well, maybe it's the stuff that I found. A whole bunch of crystals. Yeah, some of the, like, because coin purses upgrade in size as... Oh, shit! Play the guitar of healing. Well, I learned my lesson, Chief. I learned my lesson.
Terrifying roar.
That sounds cool, but how does one get metal?
Oh. through that one.
Okay. Yeah, that one sounds good. And it kind of helps to the action bar. So I tried to keep my melee ones closer together. Okay, let's try this again. That's cool, like, there's different instruments too. Flutes heal health, and while flutes recover mana. They're just like, if you ever played Star Wars The Old Republic, each class has their own, like, you know, recovering health and mana skill. That's pretty much what it is, but, you know, one instrument does the other, and you can only have one equipped at the same time, so. Unless you have both in your inventory, you just right-click on it, swap the loot with the flute, and recover mana and whatnot. But, I like it. I like it a lot. It's a good game. You know, if they would, you know, maybe listen to their community, they realize, okay, this shit's shit, so let's fix this. Because I have a great idea, because I get to a certain point, we'll go find a housing area, and we go look at that, because, see, in this game, it's all about building stuff. You know, making money and participate in giant war masses warfare, which you can still do. It's just say, you know, I like games where, you know, they let, games that let me make my own home and, you know, customizing stuff. You can do this in the game, but the catch is that only members, aka patrons, can, you know, build houses. So I can understand that because it prevents, you know, everybody and their brother from, you know, building houses and taking up all the space. I've actually found some areas that, you know, they're wide open. I'm like, nice. Because it used to be, if we look on the map, you know, it was just these areas. Everybody and their brother was crammed right in here. Now we have this area, and all these areas. Because I'm assuming if we go into here, the game won't let us walk. Like, I know there was a space in Marianopol, yeah, right here. Around here, if you try to go in there, the game would tell you, hey, go back, or we're going to kill you. Now, I don't feel like they only added, like, three areas, which is a shame in here. Because, unpaired to this, where I feel like this whole entire side of the continent just opened up. Well, there's only, like, what, three add-ons over here. Because the main source of battles over here on Aurora, because the main story goes, oh, 12 adventurers went over here to find the source of magic. Those people became gods and blah, blah, blah. And the magic was taken from the land, and now it's magically coming back. And so, and that continent called Aurora is the only place you can build castles and stuff, but this is the only place where you can build guild-based castles and stuff. It's just weird. But also the nice thing about that is, you know, because when you build a house, you know, because this is where the labor system comes in. When you want to build a house, a ship, or a castle, you need to go collect the materials for it, which is, you know, no big problem. Which is no real problem. I'm sorry, I got, like, my nose is stuffy and whatnot, so I'm trying to, like, breathe and not to mute myself every now and then, just to cough up some gunk. But let's say you want to build a boat, and you know, you find a dock area. There's like docking areas that like protect your boats and whatnot. Not like nobody can really destroy it or whatnot. It just, you know, you have a certain amount of time limit before the dock itself just disappears. Like, because you buy a plans, and you know, it's like you click right click on the inventory, and whenever your mouse on the screen will show you like where it's going to be placed, and you can do different clicks to rotate it and whatnot. Now, it's just going to give you a couple days to complete the construction of it, or it's going to go away. And it's usually, you know, if you have but the first thing you're going to do is collect the materials ahead of time, But like I said, like for a, let's say for a boat, you're really gonna need a lot of wood, a lot of stone, and some cloth. Now, the cloth may not be a problem, because the thing is, you're gonna have to get, like, it's either wool or silk or some kind that's, it's weird. And then you have to collect certain, you have to build certain parts for the boat, like the steering wheel, the sextant, like it's like a, the compass thing for it. Not some like sexual reference. It's an actual like boat thing that tells communications for old fashioned boats, I think. But you know, it'll build all the parts, which I can understand the realism for that, where you know, you just simply can't slap a whole bunch of wood and bam, you have a super awesome boat. Yeah, I can understand the realism where you're actually needing to build the parts for the super awesome boat. But also at the same time, you can, once you complete it, you can customize it with more different upgradable slots, which I thought, oh, that's pretty cool. It just, you just can't go down chopping every tree and mining every mine in sight as you please, because it's just one of those things where you have to be very conservative with your, conservative with your labor points. But that's not, because you know, if you want to build a house, but then again you have to be a member, and two, once you become a member, you know, you would generate 10 labor points every 10 minutes for members. For free to play members, you generate 5 labor points every, what was it called, every 5 minutes while logged in, and no labor while logged out. You know, that's the only downside. But you know, at low levels, as long as you go from questing and doing, you're getting your mounts quests, to, you can still plant stuff. And two, it's like a, think of it like your Farmville games or Facebook games, where you place something down and it grows within a couple of hours. You know, that's the time. You know, for, I guess if, you know, for free-to-play members is, well, I don't really generate that much stuff. Okay. Sorry, but I just got a text from my dad. It's like, hey, did you find the hammer? Like, what hammer? Trying to do a video. Leave me alone. Got a whole bunch of unwanted stuff. But where am I going? Well, I said fuck it. See, there's like this little town I've been going back and forth to, and a giant pit. Woohoo! Because I want to get more in depth in this game to give it, really give it justice. Because I think, as long as you don't chop down every tree that you see, I think you'll be okay. As long as you don't start, you know, wasting your labor points, you should be okay. Because that's just dumb, collecting everything, uprooting everything. You're like, you're just wasting your money, pretty much. Your money and labor points just to, you know, get something.
Compensating for something?
You know, the Warborn, the new race they made, you know, the storyline's pretty much you're a Warborn seeking redemption because you were controlled by some goddess lady that forced you to do a giant massacre of these certain people, so you have nightmares and blah blah blah. A new first-term recruit, welcome to the Mother's Root. And then let me hop in the pool and light all the candles. My question is, how do you get those candles float? Maybe I should have put down the flowers first and prayed, but oh well. Yeah, don't mind me. I have my giant armadillo. It's just gonna, you know, crash up the place. Make a big old mess. I'm not picking up his dung, though. That's for sure. Oh, cutscene.
I have watched you be mistreated for long enough. Now that you are under my command, I release you. You must now stand on your own. Find your own true selves. Reject all which others try to force into your hearts. Honestly, I don't know if I'm giving you a gift or cursing you yet again. Freedom can be painful, just as it is for me right now. But that's part of life. Make of your lives what you will. Someday, when our mother chooses to awaken, make her pleased at what you've become. Now go! Get out! Take your freedom from this rotten cavern and step into the dawn!
Look, it's a
Damien was right about freedom. It can be a curse as much as a gift. But he was not there when you were created. He does not know what you were made from. You are not created from the glory of the heavens, but from the shames of the hells.
Yep, in the earlier, the newbie tutorial, there's a part where you just, like, go off and massacre a whole bunch of people and stuff. You know, I had no remorse, but apparently the character does. Like, that's the name of the game. We go around and murder a whole bunch of people.
You dozed off in front of the queen's statue.
Yep.
Almost immediately, another memory floated into your dreams. You could finally recall the truth of what had happened after the Esna massacre. The Hirani had found you wandering, suddenly peaceful because Damien set you free. Your brother had rescued you from the demons and your mother, but also condemned you to a life of servitude to the Hirani. It didn't seem right. There had to be more to the story. If you could just complete the Freestorm's tasks, get them to trust you, they'd remove the stabilizer. Then all your questions would be answered. You couldn't blame the Freestorm for wanting to test where your loyalties were. There was just so much opposition to tampering with the stabilizers, even among other Warborn. The device which had once seemed such a comfort now felt like a shackle. The stabilizer had buried so many memories. It couldn't be accidental. The Hirani had done it on purpose. They wanted you afraid. They wanted you malleable.
And when you're afraid, they want you to obey. It makes like the Ronnie sound like a whole bunch of assholes. But then again, if you did so a whole bunch of species, like my, and these guys just murdered a whole entire kingdom, commanded by a demon lady, but I guess you would, you'd be kind of cautious too, like, maybe we should, put tracking devices on Omaha. Fancy gizmos that tracks what they're doing, you know, or some shit like that. Why am I scrubbing the floors? Because I know in the beginning of the game, where after the massacre dream, You're like some poor miner that has to work like a slave. And then we get fired. Then we go off all the way over here to blah 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 knows where. Scrub the floor. God damn. What else you want me to do? Ta-da! Look at my masterpiece. Aren't you proud of me? Strange how she's fucking demon, and yet we have a temple based on in her, and yet nobody has a problem with it. Yep. Nothing but our demons. Oh yes, strange random guy that speaks in a foreign language. Now there's now a whole bunch of like English subtitles besides like the main somatics and any of like the certain Salt Brotherhood people. You know, anything that pretty much explains the main portion of the game, there'd be an English person or the robotic lady. Excuse my nose. But most of the time, you know, say like the New Yen Alliance guards, you know, you pass them and they like speak in a foreign language. Hold on, please excuse my nose. God damn. I swear, it's like I have like sinuses problems the past couple of days, yet I take like all day allergy medicine and some Dayquil. Yo, after a couple hours, go to work, bam, slaps my sinuses like a little tiny bitch. But yet, I walk upstairs, yet my nose just swells up. Swells the fuck up. Ow. Goddamn crow. Here, I'll summon other crows to kill you. Which doesn't make any sense.
Does that make it a bad dude? Alright, steel bolt. There's a whole bunch of assholes in the way, so... Charge! Oh, shit. Merchant's crate. Yeah, eventually the farmer's coin purses services become crates and stuff. It's just fancier stuff that gives you more money. But actually, over time, I've actually seen money drop. I'll just straight up a couple of coins. They're nice. Can at least, like, invent, like, junk items where we just go and sell for money? That would be nice, but sooner or later we'll probably find a housing area, maybe. Because it's usually, you know, you place down, it's like the boat, you place down, you have to have the material to do so, or it's like a certain amount of time, I think. I don't know if you collect a little. Okay, what? Whoa, really? You give me a quest for it. I have to go to the auction house and buy a lily. What am I getting? What am I getting? Experience. Greetings!
Their shield or a loot? Okay, we collect. not enough items. I don't understand. Okay, we feed it. One of you wouldn't happen to be an auctioneer, nope. Just one dream merchant. You wouldn't happen to sell one random lily, would ya? I probably really, really doubt it. Wait. I'll sell you my junk. I don't want this, I don't want that. This. Oh, what's this? I don't want that. What's this? Adventurous fruit punch. I don't want this. I don't want that. I don't want this. And sell. Okie dokie. I cannot sell. Alright. Yep, I have no idea what you said. I'm gonna put all this. I like this other set. So. Because usually the item sets that you get from certain NPCs really look nice. Because, you know, this one looks nice, but I may go to leather. There's nothing to say it can't. It's just sitting in the way I'm going, and they want a plate. Alright, okay. Daily quests. What the hell? What the hell is it? Fire, wait, it's already on fire. Too bad it can't kill itself. The hell? Kill it, kill the fire. I'm surprised we haven't pulled anything else yet. That's not good. Summon crows to take out the other crows? I think I bit off too much more than I can chew. Wow, buddy, you're almost dead. Yeah. Whoa. Oh, shit. That's nice. Very effective. Oh, God. We're not boiling that too. Woo. Get one of these stacks. You use that. Man, the thing's just too good to get, like, what, 5 fucking flowers? And take on a goddamn army. Play for 5 hours. Yes, I know they're playing for 5 hours. No good, dude. I really like this game. Maybe they would tweak the labor system a little bit, because I know getting rid of it without the Korean team's permission would probably, you know, somebody would get fired probably over there. Like Crop World or whoever. Cool, we did get money from them. I just don't read the stuff that it gives me. Okay, that's a good improvement. At least I didn't feel like all my money came from the have anything that increases mana. Oh, what's this? Armor. Oh, I forgot I have a better shield. Level 31. Holy shite. Because, like, the generic armor you pull off, some of them don't look, you know, they just look normal. The other ones you get from NPCs sometime are usually unique, different from all the others. Freestorm bow, shield, or loot? Let's go with loot. Because I need a better loot. Oh, what do you want? Then we have to finish this dude's soup. What kind of quest is this? It's a weird one, but we have to make some dude's soup. Spicy soup. I don't know what kind of meat you said this was. You're eating your own can, cowboy. Muhahaha. Oh, cool, I can have both out. That's nice. I was just dispel you at the moment. Set fire! Burn, baby, burn. Don't case. Can't wait to get a better glider, because you can usually get like the experimental one, which it's okay, but it sucks. I got another character that has a blue one, which is awesome. It has special abilities and it doesn't do shit like that. You barely touch something, you fall to your pending doom. Another level up for me. It increases physical defense by 900. I wanted that cheer one because it also increases my health. Man, that one may be nice. Permanently increases aggro. Okay. Oh, well, we'll see. How long has it been? About an hour. Well, this video is slowly sailing to a close. If you like this video, feel free to let me know. I plan to play around in this video, in this game, and make some more videos. I like the game. It has its issues. I'll cover over more of the stuff, all the cool things, and maybe some of the bad things when I come across to it, but anyway, RIP headphone users. I say that now because my outro may be loud, because I got some people that are like, it's okay, and some people do that scared the shit out of me last time from a couple of my buddies. So I'll just say that ahead of time. So brace yourself, fire the cannons.